Traders, FS Picletti here. Today is Thursday, September 26th, and I'm going to be analyzing Ethereum, starting on the daily, working my way down to the 1 hour time frame. So, looks like the trend traders are still making really good money. I still think that this really is the end of a correction right here. Whether it's a wave 4 or not is debatable. And it does look to me like the end of a correction either way, though. I think this is likely a wave 1. I think this is likely a big stretched out wave 2. I think that we are very likely in a wave 3. And if it really is a wave 3, eventually it'll probably look like this for the wave 3, make a wave 4, and make a wave 5. Which I still think this is likely a wave 5 on the weekly time frame. So it'd be like a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of wave 5. So keeping all that in mind, let's take it down to the 4 hour time frame. On the 4 hour time frame, in my yesterday's video, I said I got my Fibonacci retracement from here to here. If I see 1, 2, 3 waves down, if I see a Fibonacci bounce with an engulfing move to the upside, that would be the next long opportunity. And if you've been following along with my videos, you're probably long right now and you're probably enjoying the profits from following along with the trend. So taking it down to the 1 hour time frame. Yesterday's video, I said that I think this right here is a wave A. I said this looks like 1, 2, 3 waves up for wave B. I was saying that this looks like a downtrend for a C. I told you that watch the Fibonacci levels, watch for an engulfing move up, watch for a break of Strutzer to confirm an entry to go long. So like I said, if you've been following along with my videos, then you've probably had plenty of long opportunities over the last few weeks, because I've been telling you for a couple weeks now to continue to look for longs at the end of every single three-way pullback you see. Now, I definitely wouldn't try to go long now. I would kind of expect this to go up and take out this high, potentially even further before we see another significant pullback. But next time it does decide to make a pullback, which probably won't not be too long away, I will definitely be trying to get long again at the end of the three-way pullback. I will be ignoring all sorting opportunities. I'll look at every move I see to the downside as nothing more than an opportunity to go long for the continuation of what I still think is a wave 3 of wave 5 on the much higher time frames. So don't forget to join my free Discord channel, which is linked down here in the corner. And as always, thank you and happy trading.